Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you are new here, I'm Suzie and I create contents about work from home, self-development, productivity, and freelancing lifestyle. So if you like those kind of topics, then please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and follow me on my IG account at BritxSui. So for our previous topic before, for the VA beginner series, I taught you on how to create a resume using Canva. So if you are currently watching this video right now pero hindi nyo pa napanood yung before or the first video, I recommend that you should watch that first, because in that video I explained what's the difference between the resume and the CV and when to use it. So the tutorials for today is that I'm going to teach you on how to create CV using Google template. But before that, I would like you to enjoy some of the clips I cut when we went to Hitachi port. So yeah, enjoy this first. So hope you like the very short clips na nakuha ko. Unfortunately, as you can see, ang daming mga seafoods there na available. Pero konti lang yung makakain ko doon kasi allergic ako sa mga seafood. So I just stick to fish and dried fish only. Yan lang ang hindi ako na allergy. So yun lang yung kinakain ko. But yeah, let's head now and see my laptop. So now you are currently watching my screen, and as you can see, I'm here on the Google window, but make sure that you are logged into your account so that you can go to your Google Drive. So as long as you are logged in sa Gmail account mo, you can also access your G Drive. So let's say for example, you are inside your Gmail account. You can click the three dots here at top right and then click Drive. And then here, sa Drive mo, ito yung makakapag-save ka ng mga folders, mga files. But we are not doing the G Drive tutorial for today. I'm going to teach you on how to create a CV using a Google Doc template. So, click New and then Google Docs. And then if you can see an arrow here, click from a template. So here, makikita nyo dito maraming templates for resume, for business letter, for informal letter. I like you to choose from the resume here. And ikaw kung ano yung gusto mong gamitin. And for me, I'm gonna choose something like this. And make sure na yung color branding mo is the same sa Canva na pinili mo. So right now, I'm gonna check my Canva kung ano yung color na ginamit ko doon. So here it is, my design. So paano kunin yung color? So for example, this one, I'm going to get the color brown. I'm gonna click this and then new color. As you can see, my code siya, color code. I-copy ko yan siya. But I'm not using that color. I'm going to use this color instead. This one. So I'm going to make sure click here. Kunin ko to na color. But I think, feeling ko, hindi to siya sobrang kita kasi light color siya, I need to make it darker, a little bit darker. Siguro mga ganito. Just a little bit darker lang. Kasi for sure hindi yan siya makikita doon sa background na white. So I'm going to copy this one and go back to your resume na napili mo, resume template. But I'm going to put this one as BritxSui, that one, and you can change the title here at the top. Just click it and you can type it here. And right now for us to change the color of this one, you have to highlight it, and then dito makikita mo lahat ng mga icons na pwede mo magamit, like for this one here, and then this one, and then the hex number na kinabi po doon sa, okay, that one. So I want to have something, let me choose another color instead. Yes, I guess better this. Okay, and make sure na change color mo din yung iba. So yan siya, dito mo ma-change yung font. This is just pretty the same so word na version. It's just that nasa online siya and automatically nasi-save siya. And yeah, for example, this one, let's change it. Dito, ang ginagawa ko, I make this one my one-liner post, yung ginawa ko sa Canva. This one, you can just copy and paste this one. And there you go. But hindi natin siya nakikita kasi color white siya. We have to make it black. Or hindi kasi black yung gamit nila. It's parang grayish. So let's just clear formatting. And if you will click the clear formatting, yung font style ng text, ng size, magiging the same siya kung ano yung template na nakaset. So yan. And then here, we are going to put two tables here. Let's make it 2x2. And lagyan natin siya na skills and softwares. Tools. So mostly, ito yung ilalagay natin dito kung ano yung mga alam natin gawin, at kung ano yung mga softwares na alam natin gamitin, apps, yung mga ganon. So here, I'm just going to grab the one that we had. This is one CV natin na ginawa. Put it here, and as you can see, iba siya, diba? So we have two, this one, and then we have two, this one, clear formatting para makita siya, and let's make bullet points. Okay, I will just pull out my CV before. Again, guys, this is not updated. Okay. So, para madali nating magawa siya, I will just copy and paste everything. See, as you can see that one, we have a different text. Dito, source code. And this one is Meriwether. So to make that one the same, clear formatting. So nagiging the same na siya sa template natin. And yeah, I will just update this one later. And also guys, I know as a beginner, hindi nyo pa alam talaga kung ano yung mga ilalagay dito. Again, as what I have said sa previous video ko, that I will give tutorials on each skills and softwares and tools and apps so that makita nyo kung paano gamitin and malaman nyo siya kung paano gamitin so that you can also put that into your CV and into your resume. So yeah, I need to get this one and to use the hexa code for this one. Okay, copy. And this one, put the hexa here to make the same feel of the one that we have here. You can also put the education here since we need to put all the details nandito. Ito na yung parang ano eh, full detailed kind of CV. And for example, this one, company, I'm just going to copy and paste it here from the one that I have. And you can just type it in kung wala kayong format or wala pa kayong nakalagay sa Word or sa Notepad. You can type it in. Pero kung especially if meron na and you will just going to transfer with, if you are going to paste it, ito yung mangyayari. So again, don't forget to clear the formatting para ma-disame yung color and the size and the font style. But this one, ito kasi yung naka-set niya na setting for the color. But this one, I'm gonna change it something like that. And for the month, I think I will just put 2015 because I already forgot what month it is and I'm still working on this client until now. I will also need to put this one like that. And if you don't like the dash, you can put something like this. Parang horizontal bar lang siya. And you can also make a link. This one, click this one, insert the link, and it will direct you to the website of your client. And if you want to unlink it, you can just also click remove link here at the side. Here, there's an icon, something link, and then a slash. That's an unlink icon. And that's that. For the responsibilities, I will just copy and paste this one. And click this one and then clear formatting. So, babalik siya sa original niya na font style, font size, and font color. So, yeah. So, I'm just gonna make everything the same. Copy and paste and clear formatting, something like that, and I will get back to you when done. Okay, so I'm done putting 3 work history here, but you can put as much as you like. Yung mga related or mga kumpare mga big projects lang, but if you want to also include the small gigs, then it would be okay. So here, I'm here at this education school, so probably I will just also going to copy and paste this one and I'm not sure if it's okay to do something like this. I think, and don't forget to change the color of this one. You can put the awards, you can put a reference, it's up to you. And for this one, if you want more something fancy, you can delete the, or you can make it borderless here. Just highlight it and 0 point and then And this one, let's use the color branding and make it white. So that's that. And yeah, you can also change this one to your email address, phone number, and your address. And definitely share this or download it. Click shareable, make it can view, copy the link, and share this one to our Facebook group. I am ready to boss up. Just search it on the Facebook, or I'll put the link down below. And you can download your CV here. Download, you can download it in a format of Microsoft Word or in a PDF form. So yeah, that's it. Hope you like this tutorial, guys.
See, it's very easy. So if you still have any questions about Google templates and how to use it, you can message me or comment down below so that I can answer that. And also, if you are done creating your own CV, I would like you and I encourage you to share that into our Facebook group. You can click the link down below or just research I'm Ready to Boss Up by BritxSui, and then there's a post there where you can put your link. And yeah, see you guys inside. So I also want to feature some of the other boss babes inside my group who created a resume using Canva as well. So yeah, check this out. For the next tutorial that I'm going to share with you is how to make a fancy email signature. So if you are a VA, mostly talaga nagagamitan mo to communicate is your email. So this is, let's say, necessary para makita ng mga clients mo kung ano yung ibang social media and other ways na pwede kanilang makontakt. So yeah. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then I would highly encourage you to subscribe and hit the bell button so that you'll get notified every time I publish a new video. And also don't forget to follow my Instagram account and join my Facebook group, I Am Ready to Boss Up by BritxSui. So yeah, see you inside. Bye!